Oh, shut the door. Keep the heat in. Winter is coming. Well, hello multivitamins. Ralphie here with Whisky Review 154. But before we proceed with this rather decent Dalwhinnie 15-year-old, part of the classic malts range, I've got a bit of an issue with my jumper, as you probably know if you've been following the sequence, which is very easy to do, by the way, because you just go to Ralphie's Stuff. It's my YouTube user channel, and it's all there from 1 to 154. It's all there in an index, and it's easy to find all my history of vlogs. Moving on. In a shameless and completely gratuitous spit of self-publicity, I suggested I was going to dye this jumper. We're using E150A in order to make it a shade darker. Well, I did in fact attempt to do that by sponging on the E150 and made a horrible mess, and I've not got the stuff off my fingers yet, actually. I should have worn gloves. But what I've done is I've been down to the local Manx woolen mill in Lexey, a lovely spot, Lexey, and got myself a new Manx jumper. So this one's going to have to go, guys, and going to be replaced. I'll attend to that right now. Oh dear, just didn't work out. Just the way it goes. There we are. I'll perhaps use that one for outside broadcasts, seeing as it's quite warm. Let's put the new one on. Ooh, lovely. Oh, excellent stuff. So cosy. I hope the maltsters like this. Here we go. I feel that it reflects the charring of casks, the magnificent dark moments of a fine fresh sherried Isle of Whisky with the cosiness that such a dram brings to the fireside. This will bring a dram to the fireside. If you're offered this, the person likes you. Dalwhinnie. Dalwhinnie Distillery is part of the classic malts range, as I mentioned, and it's I've got my fire on and one of the fire bricks has just exploded. I'll get back to that shortly. These traditional bothies, you see, you know, it's not like these kind of modern insulated homes. Things work a little bit differently when you're dealing with rustic stuff. Dalwhinnie, how are we doing? Right, move on. It's 15 years old, so I must say it's to Diageo's credit that they don't just bottle it and put it out there at 10 years old. Claiming that it's wonderful, delightful stuff. They have let it go the proper distance that benefits this whisky. It is considered a light one. Personally, I regard it as the honey malt. Not sweet honey, because it is a Highland whisky, so it has quite a honeyed, smooth arrival and quite a lot of subtle complexity to it, with a touch of spice, a touch of floral, and then it rounds off with a nice dry, slightly tea note. Dalwhinnie Distillery is in fact the highest distillery in Scotland, located If you go up the A9 past Pitlochry, you will see a little white distillery, beautifully whitewashed, very picturesque, out on the moors, and it is 358 metres, that's 1,160 feet above sea level. Now again, another high distillery, high located distillery, height-wise, is Breval. And funnily enough, it has been commented by the whisky fans that they tend to take on some of the attributes of a coastal malt. So if you're located at a high point in Scotland, you will develop that certain complexity and some of the marine qualities of coastal whiskies like Old Pulteney. Lovely. Smell. Incidentally, just as a footnote, there's a meteorological station, that's a weather station, right beside the distillery, and I don't know if it still is, but it certainly has been traditional that it is one of the daily tasks of the distillery manager at Dalwhinnie to go out and take the weather checks. Excellent stuff. Nose. I'm getting a touch of almost honeyed sea salt Glenlivet. There's a real rich barley sugar, fudge, honey note. Excuse me, is that fire okay? Yeah, it is. It's just the rock exploding beside it. I'll sort it shortly. In time for my end of year broadcast by the fireside. Very important that. There's a delightful barley citrus. There is almost as if there's several kinds of honey in this, all exerting themselves a little bit. And equally, this is bottled, by the way, at 43%, so I'm just going to put a wee drop of water in it. Not much. There we are. For someone who's used to blends, it's a great malt whisky to try for the first time. There's a delicious, understated, complex, rounded sweetness with a touch of bitterness as well. Absolute classic single malt character. Tea, lemon, lemon rind, grapefruit rind, heather honey, summer meadow honey, as I say, the honey malt. And to some diehard maltsters, perhaps lacking the complexity and the demands of the likes of Talisker and even Highland Park, and hence the reason they tend to dismiss Dalwhinnie, which is a shame. It's quite a chameleon whisky. At times, when I'm sipping this, I feel, is this Glengoyne? Is this a bourbon refill, bourbon Glenturret? But one thing's for sure, as a single malt, it's good quality. There is a distiller's edition with a kind of blue-grey label, but it's not as good as the basic. I'm going to give this, yes indeedy, 90 out of 100. It is a malt mark, and I'm Ralphie, and I look forward to you joining me for a Whisky Review 155, in which we are going to the United States of America, mateys, and we are going to have a rather prolonged trawl through these American spirits. See you soon.